Even though there is a button on your DVD drive to eject or close the door, but sometimes you might prefer to open or close the door using a shortcut in Windows instead of physically pressing the drive button. There could be any reason, like the physical button itself is not working or the system is a bit far from you and the button is not easily accessible. There are many third-party applications available to do the same task, but I rather not like to load my Windows with a bunch of third-party applications. So here is the tip to create a shortcut or use hotkey to eject or close the DVD drive door. First, you need to download a small command line utility called nircmd, and the link is given in the description below. Once you downloaded this small app, usually which will be inside a compressed file, unzip the file and place the nircmd file alone inside the Windows folder. Now what you only need to do is to create two separate shortcuts, one for eject and one to close the DVD door. Right click on an empty space on the desktop, point to new and then click shortcut. Type the following path in the location box: nircmd space cd-rom space close space fcol, where f is my DVD drive. You can open File Explorer to check the drive letter of your DVD-ROM and just replace the drive letter with your own. Press the next button and then type an appropriate name like close door. Create another shortcut and this time type the following path: nircmd space cd-rom space open space fcolon, and name this shortcut as open door. You don't need to type the full path of nircmd file like c:\windows/nircmd because we place this file in Windows folder, and when you type a file name without mentioning the path, then Windows will automatically search for that particular file in the Windows folder. That's it, and now you can open or close your DVD drive door just by double clicking on these shortcuts. If you want to be more productive, then you can also specify keyboard shortcuts for both of them in the shortcut properties window, or you can also pin them to the taskbar. I hope you will find this video informative and interesting.